We take a turn to the national scene and what's going on with the U.S. economy and what President Joe Biden now is doing to the U.S. economy. And joining us on the phones today, former Trump economic advisor, co-founder of the Committee to Unleash Prosperity. I like that. That sounds good. The author of Trumponomics and also senior economic contributor to FreedomWorks, Stephen Moore. Welcome to the Chad Hastie Show. How are you this evening?
I'm doing very well. Thanks so much for having me.
Absolutely. It's good to visit with you. Tell folks what you mean by putting America first when it comes to this idea of, and putting the U.S. economy first when it comes to Joe Biden and what he's actually doing.
Well, look, I mean, it's pretty clear that Joe Biden's off to a pretty bad start so far. It's been, about a week and a half, and it's been all just straight down the line, left-wing, liberal ideas. You saw what happened with the Keystone Pipeline, which was absurd that we're not building that important piece of infrastructure for our oil and gas industry. And then, of course, we're re-entering the Paris Climate Accord, which is the worst treaty in the history of the United States. It will cripple our energy industry, and none of the other countries really have to comply, especially not China and India. And then you've got the, $1.9 trillion spending bill, which is just basically a massive debt bill that is up mostly social programs, doesn't have anything to do with COVID. I mean, I could go on and on. The re-regulation. Do you remember, Chad, when Trump said, I'm going to repeal two regulations for every new regulation?
Right.
Remember that?
Yes.
Well, guess what? Biden has repealed that executive order. And he said, he said something like, this has frustrated the ability for regulators to regulate. I'm like, well, that's the whole point. We don't want them to regulate. We want them to get off the back of our businesses. So Biden clearly is not putting the economy first. Think about this. We're in an education crisis with so many schools closed down around the country. We've got to get the economy reopened in a lot of the states. We've got to deal, obviously, with the vaccine and the health crisis of COVID. And Biden's running around, shutting down our businesses because of climate change. It's crazy.
Well, as one, as an economist, and two, as someone who was an economic advisor to the president, when
right.
you see the destruction to the Trump economy, it just the willful destruction to the economy. I mean, how does that just it has to make your head explode.
It does. I'm angry. I think people should be very angry about what's going on in Washington right now. And these guys, remember, I mean, again, it was only 10 or days ago or so that Joe Biden, remember his speech, we're going to have unity, and we're going to unite the country. And then, he comes out with all these left-wing ideas. It's like Joe Biden isn't running the White House. It looks like Bernie Sanders is running the White House. And you're right. And I worked for Donald Trump as an economic advisor with my buddy Larry Kudlow and Art Laffer, and we helped write the tax plan, which was fantastic. It worked incredibly well. One of the last times I saw the president, President Trump, that is, I was joking with him in the Oval Office. I said, Mr. President, this tax bill is in the deregulation, has worked better than we even thought. I mean, we have an incredible economy before COVID, and even the growth that we have had, since the summer has been sensational. And now we've got Biden, and he keeps saying, oh, I've inherited this incredible economic crisis. It's the worst. It's like, what are you talking about? We had 33% growth in the third quarter. We had 4.5% growth, private sector growth in the fourth quarter. We got the hottest real estate market in 10 years. We've got the biggest wage gains. We were up 6.9%. I can go on and on. There's problems with the economy, but we don't need a $1.9 trillion spending bill on top of the $900 billion we just signed. Trump signed a COVID bill, 3 or 4 weeks ago before he left the office. Now they want another $1.9 trillion. Then they want another trillion for infrastructure spending. I mean, it's going on and on and on.
Stephen, what are your thoughts on the stimulus that I know is being talked about, and it was even being talked about when President Trump was leaving office? He had said, do the $2,000 stimulus. I'll sign it today. If they send me a standalone bill with the stimulus, and I'll sign it today. They never did that, of course. But
I hate that idea. I hate it. I mean, there's no such thing as free government money, right? You know this. The only way that the government can give you $1,000 to take $1,000 away from me. There's no, you know, it's not like, there's, sometimes the politician thinks it's like pixie dust and you know, it's manna from heaven. No, the government, you can only get $1,000 if the productive people who produce things, I'm not saying you're not productive, but,
yeah.
You know, somebody has to pay that money. And so it's just, it's ridiculous. And then, you know, by the way, something that people of Texas should be very angry about, is in that bill, there's a $400 billion expenditure to bail out blue states. Did you know about that?
Yeah.
Blue state. I mean, this is, you know, I'm from Illinois, so I know a lot about blue states. So it's Illinois, New York, New Jersey, Connecticut, Rhode Island, California. They're going to get all of this money for mismanaging their economy. Meanwhile, states like Texas and Tennessee and Florida that have done a pretty good job, you've got a good governor there in Abbott. You know, why should people in Texas have to pay for New York's craziness?
Visiting with Stephen Moore. So I want to go back to the stimulus, because I had a thought today that you know, one of the Biden advisors on coronavirus is saying, hey, we may have to have more shutdowns. Depending on if the new variants come over here, we may have to have more shutdowns.
Who said that?
That's one of his new health advisors, the guy out of the University of Minnesota.
Oh, that guy's really horrible. Okay. I know you're talking. He was the one who wanted a 6-week national lockdown.
Yes, yes.
That last summer, and he's you know, great. Look,
but he's in the year of the president. So here's what I'm getting at. What I fear is, this is the Democrats leading up to a universal basic income, Stephen, that they want you to get addicted to the $1,000 a month coming from the government. Is that what we're leading up to?
I think I'll put it just more broadly, that it's a dependency on government.
Yeah.
You know, so government's going to hold your hand. It's the nanny state, right? The government's going to give you free, you know, there's stuff like, getting rid of forgiveness of student loans. So people who, like my wife, who, you know, worked hard to pay her student loan, now has to pay more taxes for the people who didn't pay off their loans. I mean, how is that fair? And then how is it fair people in Texas have to pay for New York's problems? And, you know, as I said, you know, there's also in this bill a $400 a week unemployment benefit on top of the normal benefits that people get. We estimate 2/3 of unemployed workers are going to get paid more money under the Biden bill for not working than going back to work. I mean, how stupid is that?
Yeah. Obviously, the $15 an hour minimum wage. I don't see how any responsible, clear-headed person would think this is a good idea, really ever. But especially right now, in the middle of a pandemic, when mom and pop shops are hurting.
Yeah, it'll kill restaurants. It'll kill little stores, as you said, mom and pop stores, and you know, these small businesses that really struggled to keep their head above water right during the pandemic with the shutdowns and the problems and you know, reduced consumer demand. Now they're finally getting their feet back on the ground, you know, as the economy's recovering, and boom, they get hit right in the jaw with a $15 an hour minimum wage. I can't think of a worse time for that.
Yeah. Tell folks about your book, Trumponomics.
Well, I wrote the book a few years ago. I really had the great pleasure and privilege of working with Ronald Reagan. I did work for Reagan for a year in 1988, but I worked with Trump during the 2016 campaign. I was one of her senior advisors. And, you know, I cannot defend the president's actions after the election, but he did so much for this country. I mean, the way he rebuilt the American economy was just incredible. You know, we in 2019, before coronavirus hit, we had the lowest poverty rate in the history of the United States, the lowest black and Hispanic unemployment rate in the history of the United States, the biggest wage gains in 20 years, you know, the best stock market ever. I mean, I could go on and on and on. The best housing market, you know, the thing, remember how good things were?
Yeah.
You know, this time last year, before COVID
hit? Yeah.
I mean, I think if it hadn't been for COVID, Trump would have won a 40-state reelection landslide.
Yeah, I think so. How bad could this get under Joe Biden?
I'm nervous about it. I think that you've got a lot of left-wingers that want to increase our debt, increase our spending, increase regulation, kill our energy industry. I mean, do you know what percentage of our energy today that we use throughout the country? It comes from oil, gas, and coal.
What's that?
80%.
Yeah.
They want to go to zero.
Yeah.
These people are nuts. They're crazy. you know, you're there, obviously, in Texas, right near the, you know, the great oil.
Oh, he's got everybody worried out here.
What's that? Well, he should be worried. I mean, these people, look, folks, if you thought and Joe Biden, I was surprised that Joe Biden got 46% of the vote in Texas. I mean, God, he's going to kill the oil and gas industry. That's millions of jobs in Texas that would be flushed out. And they say, oh, we're going to build solar panels. I mean, come on. Anybody think we're going to be able to power a $22 trillion industrial economy that makes cars and steel and, you know, the technology and we drive around in our cars? We're going to get that energy from windmills? How stupid is that?
Yeah. Stephen Moore, appreciate your time today. Senior economic contributor at FreedomWorks, also former Trump economic advisor. A pleasure visiting with you this evening, and let's visit again soon.
I hope we can. Take care. Have a great night.
Thank you. That's Stephen Moore here on the Chad Hastie Show.